Yeah, this rock
has a coral on it. And I'm doing my best to position it down here so that it can grow. Somebody keeps knocking it away. I have my suspicions. Look at all this sand all over here. Let's see if I can catch him on camera. There. Kind of nestled it down in a little bit deeper this time.
Let's see if that does any good.
Hey everybody, Reef Girl here, and welcome to my channel. As I was reviewing this footage to see what was going on, it struck me how relaxing it was. Watching my fish swim in and out, watching the torch and the plate corals just kind of waving in the breeze, and I really enjoyed it. So I thought rather than just edit it down to 2 minutes of setting up what the problem is and then showing what the solution was, I would just keep the whole thing intact and leave it with you. Throw it up on a big screen, have it kind of in the background, but it's really interesting to watch how the fish all behave. This is right at the front of my tank, and you can see back at the back of the tank in the distance the caves, and the fish spend a lot of time swimming around back there. So I hope you enjoy this. I'll tell you right now, I have no conclusive answer as to which fish was doing this, but I do think it was the blenny. At the very end, I'll show you my solution and a little bit of a realization that I came to about this particular spot for this particular coral. But in the meantime, sit back, relax, enjoy, try to stay awake, and I'll just leave this with you. Oh, but just in case you do fall asleep, or if you never actually make it to the end, if you like the video, why not give it a thumbs up? And consider subscribing to my channel if you haven't already. There is a lot more to come, and I'm doing my best to get more videos together and published because I'm really far behind, but I'm trying to catch up. Okay, back to the video. Thank you. Blenny, incoming. the Blenny is about to do here makes me pretty sure he's the one that's been responsible for moving this thing all over the place.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I had no idea blennies would spit sand like this until I watched this video. At this point, I just stopped recording and left it overnight, fully expecting to see a problem the next morning. But that didn't happen. I realized I owe an apology to Mr. Blenny because there's actually a tunnel between the inside of the barnacles and the outside of the barnacles. And I think what I was doing was blocking the little guy's passageway, kind of his little secret tunnel. So, sorry little guy. Now that he's moved a bunch of sand though, he seems to be leaving the coral in place. The sand is all piled up and I'll kind of redistribute that. But for now, well, I'm happy to leave it the way it is. Polyps are out, it's looking happy. And yeah, so thanks for watching. If you hung in till the end, I'm totally impressed. Stay safe, everybody.